It's August 31, 2017, downbeachbuzz.com. Yep. Took a little ride up to Philadelphia Avenue on the Ventnor Boardwalk this afternoon. Just so I can enjoy the noise, the sound, the clackety-clack of a dune being constructed along the Ventnor Boardwalk. Some photographs. So I got some stuff from Margate today. That's August 31. And some Ventnor. Let's see here. Give you a little preview of Labor Day weekend. How's that? You know, a lot of the work that was done in Ventnor already, to the best of my knowledge, I think a lot of it has already been eroded and washed away and sent down to like Ocean City and Stone Harbor and Wildwood. That's where it all ends up, all this sand that was excavated off the ocean floor just off the coast here of Absecon Island. Crazy. And now we are looking at something. I believe it's right. This is right next to the Margate Fishing Pier. And I think this is Exeter. I'm pretty sure. Or Essex. Or Exeter. Whatever. One of the two. And you can see they're sinking these concrete basins. And to the best of my knowledge, this is a part of the process for a long-term solution for draining Lake Christie. And this has got to be a long-term solution since I'm only taking a good guess, but I just thought maybe there'd be some announcement. The Army Corps of Engineers is not documenting it on their daily reports. But if you take a look, and if I can zoom in here a little bit, they almost look like they are pre-made, prefab concrete. I wish I got here a little bit earlier, but you see they're just throwing crap in here. There's a good foot of water here. And the this might be Weeks Marine or might be Walters Marine. This dude's not too happy seeing me taking photographs. All these knuckleheads in their hard hats. I think they're getting tired and frustrated. But then again, the homeowners and the visitors and the tourists and the people who look forward to summer, they're not too happy about these guys either. But these guys are pretty loud and obnoxious too as this project wears on. You can hear them talking openly about how much they don't like doing this and they're ticked off and I've heard foul language, that's for sure. Anyway, let's see what else we got here. What can we look at? So now they're after a hard day's work of sinking these are all throughout the work area. This is, I think, the long-term solution. And all these areas, first off, they dug all this crap out. Then they had to fill it back in. And in between those two processes, you know, digging it out and then filling it back in, there was Lake Christie for at least a week, right? I kind of lost track. Imagine the people living right here. It's nonstop. Fix a problem, make a problem. Make a problem, fix a problem. And who's paying for it? They're not going to eat it. The Army Corps and Weeks Marine, they're not going to eat into their profit. Now they're going to put another invoice in. They don't care about making mistakes because they can go back to the till and get paid more money. It's a great job to have. It's really shameful how they waste money. The one person who I haven't seen down here keeping an eye on things is Congressman Frank LoBiondo of Ventnor. He's the guy that made sure that money was available to be given to Weeks Marine for this project. He's not down here keeping an eye on things. You know, maybe shaking hands, taking selfies with people, signing autographs. But he's nowhere to be found anywhere near this project. But it's his baby. And then right here at Frontenac, when you come down, when you walk up the steps and then down here over the bulkhead, take a look at what you're looking at here. This is incredibly treacherous right here. Because this is a kind of a raised up area. Let me go to the next photograph here from a different angle. As you can see, it's starting to collapse. They don't have guards. This thing is still treacherous. You get a kid that comes over here, they fall right through here into about a foot, 2 feet of water right here. gives you some kind of an idea, right? So when you come down these steps, you take one slight wrong move and you go right down into this water because this keeps on getting worse. They should be pumping this out. Let me just stay on this for a moment. This is a real problem right here. The Army Corps and the DEP, they don't give a flying hoot about safety. It's constant public safety hazards. And I'm not talking about Zika virus or bacteria, which is bad. I'm talking about you come over these steps, you make one wrong move, and you're going into it, and you're falling right into it right here. And you saw the clowns they hired as guards. They're falling asleep. It's a death trap. Okay, maybe that's a stretch. But our beaches are construction zones intersecting with the peak summer season as we approach Labor Day weekend. And here's all that, those corrugated pipes. They're almost plasticky, or what I believe is the new long-term solution for drainage. But what do I know? I'm just a guy with a camera and a website. The entire beach is a construction zone. And here's a good foot of water just sitting here. This is not being pumped out. In some of these areas, you can work your way down here. They are not protected. They are not safe. Kids can get down here. And you can see here they're trenching it out more to kind of make way for drainage or the upcoming storms that we see a lot of storms heading our way. Maybe Irma will make it here. Who knows? I also noticed they started putting up some of these. Well, they finally did. These are good ideas. But these portable signs, beach closed, no beach access, at these street ends on Atlantic Avenue, and this is at the corner of Osborne and Atlantic. Because that's a long haul. That's a long-ass haul to get from here to the corner all the way down to the beach to find out, oh, it's not open. That's a good 10-minute walk, especially if you're towing three kids and you got all your beach chairs and all that junk, right? So at least on a couple of streets, you see these signs, but it's not consistent throughout all the areas of Margate. Keep that in mind. But it's nice to see a whole bunch of these. I saw them around Nassau and Osborne. And some updated photographs of what they are building. I'm not sure if it's getting buried or who knows. Disgusting. And then yesterday, the cliffing in Ventnor. I was surprised by that. Where is it? This is yesterday. And you can see what's happening here is during high tide, the water is coming over this lip that forms at the surf side, at the surf end where the surf meets the beach. And this is just north of some of the work that the Army Corps did a few months ago when they were doing a couple of blocks in Ventnor before they changed their mind and said, no, we have to go after Margate instead. I believe the sand from that work made its way along the surf line here and created a lip. And so when high tide came, the water came in and these big giant pools are forming. And that's one of the ramifications, one of the negative effects of re-engineering a beach. That's what you get. Start messing with the beach. Look what you're going to get. And look at the cliffing. It starts eating away at the beach that they just built. They made the sand and the beach higher in elevation, and they made it wider. And this sand is not very pleasant, let's just say that. Is it going to bleach? Is it going to get better? I don't know. But this is a different type of sand. This is not something where you see people sitting in. They're sitting in the back. No one's sitting up front. But look at that cliffing. You absolutely get hurt if you're a kid or a senior. Take a look at that. Is that crazy or what? And then not only does a cliff, but then there's a pretty, I'm not going to say a steep slope, but you got to be really careful. And when there's a strong undertow or there's rip currents, take a look at that. You can get pulled right out. You see how it slopes like that if you fall off the cliff here? There's something about this that I just don't like. But I'm sure the DEP knows how to save lives much better than me. And a lifeguard, that is. And that's the beach. I got eaten away. All that work they did here got eaten away already. So what do you do when you come down to the beach? Which side are you going to sit on? That's the beach in Ventnor right now, during high tide. Good job, Army Corps. Nice. Good job.